Hi, this is Matt from the Dirty Lab Coat, and today we're going to be doing a quick little photosynthesis experiment where we're going to be watching a plant of Nanochloropsis consume CO2, and as it consumes CO2, the pH is going to go up. So the first thing you're going to want to do is fill up a container, in this case I have a centrifuge tube, with your algae culture. Nice thick algae culture is the best. Then, power tools! Drill a small hole in the top of this. Now you've created a chamber, a photosynthesis chamber. Here's a pH probe. It's best if you have this connected to your computer so you could data log it. And then what you're gonna wanna do is stick the pH probe into the culture, and you'll wanna make it so that the water squirts out. That way there's very little water space that's in there, okay? Now at this point, start tracking the pH change on your computer. And you're gonna be looking for a slope, and this is almost exactly like a P versus I curve. So at this point, you've got a lot of photosynthesis taking place. So your pH at this point is going to be going up. So you get a slight change. This is much more dramatic if you're gonna be measuring oxygen, but if you don't have an oxygen probe, the pH probe works just fine. You might wanna do this, start it, have it track, have it data log, and go to lunch with your students, come back a little bit later on, and then check this out, and it'll go up. Now the cool thing is, leave this in at night. Here, I can make nighttime happen. That's the power of science. At night, if you leave all this plugged in and data logging overnight, the pH will actually go down because your algae is going to be respiring and consuming O2 and producing CO2. The CO2 in the water will turn into carbonic acid, driving the pH of the system down. Anyway, that's Matt from the Dirty Lab Coat. Special missions are our specialty.